My name is Roger Lextrait. I am the manager of the island of Palmyra. The island is situated 1,000 miles southwest of Hawaii. Indeed, Palmyra is a very beautiful island. That's why I live the last 7 years here. The perfect Robinson Crusoe life and harmony with nature. Now, I'm going to show you this beautiful island. This is the swimming pool and the front of the house.
Yahoo!
Et voilà qui revient.
Ah, mon gros dadou.
Yeah, c'est des gros chiens.
Yeah, ça c'est my son. The old my son. Come here.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed that video. When I was a little boy, I read Ernest Hemingway, The Old Man and the Sea. I was 12, 13 years old, I can't really remember. And I left with my bicycle and all my bags for the Brittany, where the fishman was. And all the police in France was looking for me. They caught me smoking Gauloise and the train station. The adventure beginning that day and never ever stop. And life is many things to touch, to smell and to experience. If you have a dreams, you got to accomplish that dreams. Or how can you look yourself in the mirror in the morning when you brush your teeth? I have a great pleasure making that video and to show it to all you guys. Until then, aloha from Palmyra. We are going to come up for a little vacation and I will be back in 3 months. Aloha.
Hey, here we go. We're coming for our vacation in Honolulu. If I can't stop that damn thing.
This is Ange doing the wood.
Yeah.
Here's Roger repairing his fishing net. Cute little shark, it's got some big holes in there, and he has to mend it. Making sure he does it okay.
This is Dudutch. Dudutch. That's one of Raoul's. You see, we have the coconut where we make the milk, the coconut milk with those coconuts. This is the house where we live. We have video, bed, very nice little house. We're going to go inside now. This is the house inside. Angie's cleaning up. We have the video here. And here we have another bed. Here is Ange doing some painting. She's creating some beautiful painting and some rocks. And here we have, I guess, some fish. Here we have a chicken making some eggs on a... Ooh. We try to find the eggs. Hey, here we are. We're going to make some omelette. We have about 4 eggs a day. Here we have some chicken here. The beautiful. And Ange is doing some Palmyra t-shirt. We sell them to the yacht for $20. And we sell a lot of them. And the way to do it is like this. She's putting the hank on it, like that, voilà. Everywhere. No. And now we're going to show you the t-shirt.
And this is the finished product.
This is the tank where we have 120,000 gallons of water for our bath. And this is the bath. We're going to show it to you. And here is the bath. It's a very nice bath. We come here almost every day to get cool. Sometimes it's 95 degrees in Palmyra and it's not easy to get cool.
Ah. Hey. Yeah. Yes, I got the 2 dogs with me. And men, no, they don't want to come. Anyway, that's a beautiful bath. Oh boy, isn't that fresh here? I don't think they like that too much, huh? Hey, good guy. What a beautiful day in Palmyra today. And man, I just love it. So I'm going to do a little show on you with the coconut crab. This is a coconut crab here. See? Get it this way too. They have four antennae, you see? Two here, two for direction, and two for smell. They live to be about 60 years old. That one is about, I will say, 35 years old. The way to handle a coconut crab is like this. You take him like this, put your hand here, and you put the two big claw and the top, and you hold him. If you put him like this, he will go slip after a while. You see those two big claw? You don't want to get your finger on that. What they do, they go up the tree at night, get their coconut and peel it and make their bed with it. This is a posh of oil here. You see, if I touch that, it will not like that. The posh is full of coconut oil. During the period of May to October, he goes under the ground, dig a big hole, and stay there for 3 months. He changes his shell at that time. He put a new one in. When he come out, he's a little bit bigger and very soft. The shell is soft. They do that every year. Hello. His name is Saddam. Hello, Saddam. Be a good boy, Saddam. Be a good boy, Saddam. Here is Saddam, and I find a friend for Saddam here. So the traditional way to cook them is to broil them in water, or put them in the fire, and when they very, the shell is very dark, about 15 minutes, it should be cooked. What do? You take the meat, and you dip it in that posh of oil, and that's the traditional way to eat it. And the Marquesas, their name is Cabello. Cabello. Hello, boys. That's a good dude. That is a good dude. I'm my dude. Hi, dude. Hi, dude. Hey, dude. Hey, dude. Okay, we go down. Allez, dude, we go down. Hey, hey, we go down.
Ange got some coconut. You see them in the barrel here. Yeah, we just got the coconut. I go up the tree. And in Palmyra, you have to do everything by hand. Huh? so it's a good spot.
A demonstration how to open a coconut, a green coconut. First you have to go to the palm tree to get it, and you have to cut it. That was delicious.
Roger is taking off the husk of the brown coconut here. And we're going to grate the coconut flesh inside to make some curry with it later.
Et voilà.
And here we have Ange. She's raping the coconuts to make the curry with the fish. With the eyes of Floppy looking. Hey, Dadu is coming.
Dadu? Dadu? Yeah.
Oh, Kanadeska! Inasushi Maru! Hey, I'm driving my car.
We have a manta ray. She is beautiful, look at that. Yeah. We have two big manta rays in the front of us. Real beautiful. Yeah. Whoa. Look at those baby. Right to us. Yee-hee. Very beautiful. They're pretty big. Right at the front of the dinghy, they're swimming with us. Youhoo! Et les revoilà, our two manta rays, right at the front of us. Beautiful animal to watch, so graceful. I ride them sometimes. I go on their back and ride them. Yeah, beautiful. Like a plane underwater. Beautiful. Woo-hoo. I would love to ride there now, but it'd be very hard to film. And the other one is on the front. That's the magic of Palmyra. You have 200 birds following you. You have to go between the ray. It's a pretty amazing island. Here she comes again. She's just gone under the dinghy. That was something else. Here we have a manta ray again.
Catch the mullet this morning. Ange did it. Now we're going to show you how to cook it. A little cooking demonstration. I used to be executive chef and I owned two restaurants before, so I know how to cook. The mullet are here and the marinade. They marinate for 3-4 hours with a little bit soyu, some onions, garlic, peppers, little bit olive oil. And basil, we leave it marinate. Now we have the garlic here. We have the butter to make the sauce. The sauce is already made here. And now we're going to cut the garlic, the onions. And here we have the rice cooking and the cafe, the water for the cafe, because tonight we're going to go for the lobster tonight. We're going to take them on the reef and low tide. So we need the cafe to get going. Hey, we're going to cook it. So look at it. You have to make sure your pot is very, very hot to seize the fish. So you put the fish in. Very hot. Okay, with the residue and the pan from the fish, I put a little bit of oil and I fry the onions and the garlic now until they brown. And after that, I will put the sauce on it. I will make the sauce. Okay, now we're going to make the sauce. So, look at that. This is tomatoes. We have tomatoes, garlic, onions, vinegar, little bit soyu on it. So here we go, sizzling. I use the residue of the fish to cook, and we're going to leave it reduce, and we're going to put little bit raw butter on it. When it's out of the fire, mix it with it, and it will be the end of it. Et voilà! So now we're going to finish the sauce. So little bit butter, what we're going to do, we're going to take the pot, bring it here, very gently, here. You never put the butter raw, and little bit cognac. We have little cognac and up, not too much cognac. Little bit butter, and now you go like this. You never broil the pot. You mix the butter and you broil. And man, that's going to be delicious. Now we go in here. That's the fish. We are going to take all the grease out. We don't want grease. And We put the sauce on the top now. Mmm! Yum, 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 yum.
Now, we're going to test the finished product. And a beautiful Palmyra. Here is Jenny. She's going to be 21 tomorrow. So we're going to get some lobster tonight. She looks like she's 21.
Well, thanks.
Those birds are called the sooty terns. They come two times a year in Palmyra. They do two migrations. It's approximately 1 million birds. Here we have some brown booby with the chick. The chick is about 1 month and a half, something like that. Here we have a mother with a very little chick. See the little chickie? Two little brown booby. Very small, maybe a few days old. Here we have a brown booby, about 2 months old. And on the top, we have a red-footed booby with this baby. That's a red-footed booby with a baby. It's the biggest booby, red-footed booby colony in the world with the Galapagos and Palmyra. That's a brown booby, little bit older than the two small ones than we see. Hey, another red-footed booby. It's very hot. It's about 95 degrees today here in Palmyra. This one is about, I'll say, 4 months old. We show you the end of Straw Island here. And this is Ansley Island. We have some birds of paradise on this island. And about 12 years ago, I made a motu with a nice little house, a fare, barbecue, and everything there. So we're going to look the birds of paradise. Here we have a booby bird. Here we have a small booby. Who is that? He said, who is that? He's about 5 months old, I think, something like that. Here we have the birds of paradise. They're very beautiful birds. Quack, quack. Birds of paradise. Here we have birds of paradise with this little. The mother no want me to approach it. The little birds of paradise here, as you see him. Very cute. The mother is not very keen to let me look at it. That's a red-footed booby with a little one under her neck. I don't know if you see it. We have the little one here. You see it? Under her. We have a brown booby, a very small brown booby, as you see. Oh my God, what's going on? That's a brown booby about 4 months old, I think. Very cute. Little ball of cotton. Here we go in for a ride with a dinghy. We have plenty of birds on the top of us, if you can see. It's nice to get a ride in a dinghy and have 200-300 birds following you. Okay, we are entering Palmyra, like every boat will be. With the marker. The marker are right at the center and the end of the island, they're on the back of the island. We're going to focus and you're going to see them. Voilà. You see the notch on the tree and the white marker on the front. That's the entrance of Palmyra. You see the notch on the tree, the V and the tree, and the front low on the reef is a white marker. That's what the people coming to Palmyra should look for. Until they find that they should stay at 30 feet of water. So from far away, that's what they see. Not very easy. Hey, here we have a little colony of booby birds. Look at that tree. How many birds on the tree? I am up the mass of couscous, filming a little view on Palmyra. Here we have the view of the airport. We're going to see the boat run away here. Here is couscous, my 47 foot steel boat. I sail all over the Pacific, north and south, for the last 15 years. It has the camp view from the mast. Here is couscous, my 47 foot steel boat. I sail all over the Pacific, north and south, for the last 15 years. Now we are inside the couscous. This is a carving that I got when I was on the Solomon Island. And the Solomon, they do beautiful carving, especially mask. This is a kava bowl from Fiji with some shell, and here this is a knife made of shark teeth from the Kiribati Island, and the two other things are the flute, one from Vanuatu, one from the Solomon Island. It's like a museum of the South Pacific on couscous. And here we have the globe of the world and the mark, the black mark on it, is the voyage I did with the couscous tree. And that's my little fetish who follow me thanks I sell. He got on fire once. He's been all over the Pacific, all over the place with me. And I have my watchdog. Woof, woof, here. And I have another animal, stuffed animals. We're still inside couscous here. An ange is very lazy. This. The ange relax after a good day of filming today. And she did the fishing this morning. T2 Foxy 2, this is the Palmyra station couscous. Do you copy?
Yeah, copy, fine. How are you tonight?
Hey, I'm doing fine, Ron. I'm doing fine. It's a beautiful day in Palmyra today. Ange did some fishing this morning, and she's catching lots of fish. So with Ron away, we're going to eat the fish. Also, we make a video of the coconut. I go up the coconut tree, she filmed me. We did a superb video.
And it's a sunny day with east wind about 15 knots. You copy?
Yeah, copy. Why you getting more lazy making her fish now, huh?
Yes, yes, yes. Hey, she's got to be part of the operation, huh? Do you have any message for me?
No, nothing new. I did tell you that JoJo called the other day and told her you're coming up, so she's going to get me some mail later, but that's all I got for you right now.
Yeah, okay. Very well. Anyway, we're almost ready to go, and we're finishing the video, and we're going to see what that hurricane is doing, and we will be underway, huh? You copy?
Yeah, Fernando is not a hurricane, it's a storm. Also, Camilo is asking how you're doing and when you're coming up. So a few other people are asking what's up. So, yeah, just look at the window and come up when you feel comfortable, and I'll give you the weather as you come up.
Roger. If you say Dave and Camilo, just say hello for me, huh? Just to say hello for me, and I hope Janice is doing better, huh? Give him a big hug from the both of us, Ange and me, huh? I hope she's doing better, over.
Yeah, the second day down here, boy, this one hit her big time. She's just now kind of like peeking up and seeing what's going on.
Okay, very well. Everything is fine here in Palmyra. We're having a beautiful time. So I'm going to go cook the dinner. Today we're making mulette with a butter cognac sauce. So that's going to be delicious. I wish you was there.
Yeah, I wish I was too. Hey, have you heard from Trish recently? I got a message for him. A request to check on something. You haven't heard from Trish, have you?
Negative. No answer from Stretch, over.
Yeah, okay. All right, let's see. I gotta get
Bravura
and think
goodnight.
Well, it should be pretty close, and that's about it. I gotta get out of here early also.
Okay, hey, I will stand by for a while. That will be Palmyra Station, Whiskey Tango, Sierra 2472. Will be clear, standing by.
Bravura.
Roger and Mike are coming back from a fishing trip. What have they in the dinghy?
Hey, we got some fish.
About 60 pounds of fish, half a pound, we're going to have a good time. Yeah, you want a fish? My God, I know we are going to eat fish tonight. They are mullets. And we got about 60 pounds. Okay, this is a mullet. I'm going to show you how to clean a fish efficiently, professionally. So you put the fish like that, you put the knife behind that, you put your hand like this, and you slice the knife. You have to have a sharp knife. And you go like this. You see, you have some very beautiful fillet. No meat on the bones. You do the other side same way. Yeah. Now we'll do another one, just to show you. So you slice, go to the bone, turn, put your hand on the top.
like this. And now I'm going to show you. I take only the good part of the fillet, which is here. Huh? And those fillets, we have absolutely no bones. And I'm going to show it to you how to cook those with butter, garlic, onions, ginger, and a butter cognac sauce. And that's what we're going to do next. Show you how to cook the fillet of mullet. Aloha. Fish, then you see the mullet marinated with a yashida gourmet sauce, garlic, and onion. See, then we chop. See, and now we're going to go to the to our little camping stove. We have two cooking house. That's one of them. That one don't have any ceiling. So we're cooking some breadfruit on the left, and the tea, the little pot on the right. She's coming back from her swimming.
Thank you. Cheers, Roger. It's a healthy life.
Chin chin.
Woo-hoo!
Hey, I just hired a new cook because Ange do not like my cooking anymore. She's cooking the mullet, who are marinated in yashida gourmet sauce with onions, garlic. We're going to make a butter cognac sauce, and if you could smell, he smell wonderful. Hey, chef, can we get a smile?
Oh, maybe. Ah, smells good.
Here we go. No,
no.
We have in dinner.
Oh,
you want to see?
This looks delicious.
And here we have it. Ooh, look at that. That's going to be good.
It's really good.
We are in a little party with the boat runaway. Here is Ange, happy, I hope so. And here we have the crew of runaway. They are the couple who's going to replace us when we're gone. Here is Jenny. And Mike, the mate.
Hi, Mike.
We are grilling some fish, as you see, and up there, for the dog. The dog likes to have the fish grilled. And look at Tutu here. He loved that. That's good, Tutu. That's good, Tutu? Good dog, Tutu, huh? Yum, yum, huh? Good dog. And the ramp where we eat our meal, and we're going to show you later a little cooking demonstration there.
We have a beautiful view.
I hope you enjoy that video. Today's another day. We're going to go to Barron Island. We're going to show you Barron Island. And it's a beautiful day. We're going to do some diving, catching fish. We're going to do hearts of palm. We're going to show you all that on the video. Aloha.
We are going under the tree where we play with a rope. A nice path. Now we're going to a pass. It can be 10 knots of currents on that pass sometimes. It's to go to the center lagoon. When it's 10 knots of currents, impossible to go through. You can see the water forming a little bit here. And now we are on the center lagoon. I would like to show you, last year we have a big drought here, 6 months with absolutely no rain and sun every day. If you see the palm tree here, lots of them do not have any top, they die. And here they are. Let's look again. See them here? No top on the tree. That's on the middle lagoon. We follow in the shore here. Here is Ange, walking on the beach. Machine, a pass that I made 2 years ago, we call it Roger's Pass, Roger Pass, it is. That helps the lagoon to be clear and more flow of oxygen to the lagoon. And also we can go that way to Barron Island more easy. Now we are on the last lagoon, the way out at sea, the one out at sea. We have the turtle hole here. We have the turtle hole. You see it, the blue spot here in the middle, and the pass, we just passed the Roche Pass here. It's a very, very, very big lagoon, this one. And this is Barron Island, very far out at sea. I have a little house on the left
side up there with a barbecue. We barbecue the lobster, the fish, and we catch water up there also. Very good diving is on the right of Barron Island. It's spectacular. Now we are on Barron Island. Another beautiful beach. Very pretty place. Lots of lobster on the reef when the water is low at night. Here is the wood I gather to make the barbecue. I'm going to show you the barbecue, which is here. See it here? That's where we grill the fish and the lobster and everything. And here we have the hermit crab. Our camp is totally filled with them. They all over the place. Look at that. You put little bird food on the floor and there. And we have them here too. See them. Hey, talking about hermit crab all over the place. They try to eat the dog food. And look at that, how many. They try to get on the path. That's the way we preserve the dog food, or after 10 minutes, it'll be 200 crab on that. Here we have again Isabelle. Oh, super! She wants to get her fish! And today we're going for a big dinghy ride to show you around the island. We have beautiful color, blue turquoise. This is a point on Barron Island. And next, we're going to go to the end of Barron Island, which you see here. We're going to do some diving and try to catch some fish there. Another view of Barron Island. We have Mr. Shark coming to see us. We catch some fish là. Mr. Shark will come a little bit too close. Yeah, they smell the fish. We just catch lots of fish. Here is Tutu with a shark.
Aita. Good dog, Ta. Good dog. Oh, that's a good Ta. Is this his tattoo with the shark? You don't want to give it to nobody. Hey, they catch a rat. Here is Floppy with a rat. Oh, they do get the rats now. It's two to turn, and he's got a good one. Et tata, maman, j'en ai rat!
And here we have Roger doing his daily exercise run with the doggies.